Good morning, everyone. We are here with Emilio Roman, Vice President, EMEA Sales Business Solution Group of Bitdefender. Good morning, Emilio.
Good morning, Stefano.
How are you?
Very well, thank you. How are you?
Oh yes, I'm well too. Yes. We started this interview last Bitdefender Virtual Partner Conference EMEA, the future of cybersecurity go to the next level. This sentence is an important sentence. Which is the meaning of these phrases in your position and in your company?
Well, in fact, it's the headline of what we could see with many of our partners around the EMEA, and it was a few hundred of them joining a few days ago from all across Europe, the Middle East, and Africa. And I would say that it comes very much related to the three pillars of what we shared with our partners. The first one about the business opportunity itself, the joint business opportunity of our partners together with Bitdefender, the one that we have today, the one that is in front of us, right? Secondly, what they can expect in terms of technology. And not only technology, but the services. And I'm talking here about MDR, Managed Detection and Response Services, which can be integrated with their own security services, right? So what they can expect from our technology and our services. And third, and asynchronous, the other two, is about what they can expect moving forward from Bitdefender as a partner of theirs, right? The simplicity of our partner program and our channel slash sales strategy. So those are the three things, and that was the headline of, you know, all that we shared with our partners.
Yes, in fact, what is your relationship with cloud partners? I see that during the virtual partner conference, we spent a lot of word about this kind of partner.
About the MSP, the cloud partners?
Yes, MSP and also cloud partner.
Mm-hmm. Well, at the end of the day, we've been seeing a number of trends that we were going through before this year, before the pandemic started. Yes. And after the few quarters of this year, 2020, we have seen some of those trends being accelerated. And one clear one to us, to our partners, is the managed security services, right? In those regards, we have a complete offering for our MSP partners and their customers since long time ago. Meaning we as a vendor have our complete portfolio that can be invoiced per usage, invoiced on a monthly basis, purely pay-as-you-grow model that it's been, I would say, of key importance during this acceleration phase of the trend itself, of the MSP services. A big percentage of our business, and by so a big percentage of our current partners, are working with us on that model, on the managed security services model. And lastly, I mean, in 2020, it's not only, as I was saying before, about the technology, our product itself, the endpoint protection, or even the endpoint detection and response, the EDR technology, but the services itself. So we are getting very, very strong, as I said before, on the managed detection and response services with mm-hmm. a complete SOC, state-of-the-art technology and great experience of the team in our SOC based in the US. By the way, the data is stored not only in the US, but in Europe, in Germany. So we are offering those services even to our MSP partners for them to complement their own managed services with their customers. And we are flexible. We give different flavors of those services depending on what their needs. Depending on what their needs are. We have a couple of flavors, what we call the expert advice and the expert response. So the first one is to back up their own socks of our MSP partners. The second one, we even act on a 24/7 on their behalf, if that is what they need, particularly for customers where the 24/7 immediate response is essential, right? That's key importance to us. The other one is embracing, I would say, the digital channels, right? Our partners are looking for simplicity in the channel program itself, and I would say even more importantly in the way that they operate with vendors. We took that feedback very seriously. With a number of our distributors around EMEA, we are co-working, we are integrated in their cloud platforms, in their marketplaces, right? All our, I would say, subscription-based products for the MSP business, it goes through their marketplaces, through their cloud platforms. So I would say that, you know, both trends that really accelerated this year, and taking the feedback of our partners, we have leveraged very much on them.
The cloud service accelerated a lot during this year and also until 2024. You say that you expect 40% of mid-size companies to use them by 2024. Yes. It is an expectation, really expectation. There are some sign about this this kind of percentage, or there are some other situations, some other.
Absolutely. It comes with the managed detection and response services, and this is what a number of consultancy companies and analysis made throughout the world is pointing out, and you're very right. It's the expectation is that 40% of the mid-sized enterprises are going to be using managed detection response services by 2024. And to your question, Stefano, yes, we are definitely seeing that is one of the, I would say, hottest segments in the security arena, in the security market these days, where the growth is, I would say, bigger than in other segments in the security space. We invested big time since a number of years ago in our SOC for providing the managed detection and response services. And normally they are provided using not only, but big part of it, our product, our technology, EDR in the cloud. And I have to say that as a differentiator versus many other vendors in the space, we have that technology, meaning the endpoint detection and response, not only in the cloud, but on premise for those government customers, critical infrastructure type of customers that are not yet ready to go cloud with their security and the security technology. We have it on-prem as well, giving those type of services on-premise, what we call the managed endpoint detection and response. So yes, to your question, we are definitely seeing an acceleration in there. And that is the very big joint opportunity that we shared with our partners during the partner conference. So it is about the endpoint protection, where we continue to be leaders with investment in our technology for the last 19 years, right? But on top of that, it's about the next generation endpoint security with our EDR technology in cloud, on-prem, together with the endpoint protection or standalone that can be used with any other end protection product in the market, and the managed detection and response services, together with our channel, integrating those services with the with our partners as security service, regardless if they are, I would say, traditional value-added resellers or systems integrators, or they are managed security services providers.
Yes, managed detection and response services has become more robust for strong for a partner than you expected. Yeah. But during this period 2020 from 2021, which will be the most important aspect that you expect, especially from for the next year, because this year are extremely complicated, but not for security. I think.
Yeah, exactly.
2021. Which is your opinion for you and for partners?
Well, we are definitely very optimistic, and we have a strong plan together with our partners for the following year, starting by 2021. First, we are getting stronger and stronger together with our partners in the mid-size and large enterprises, right? Undoubtedly, we have a big market share in the small and medium companies, but we're getting stronger and stronger in the mid-size and in the large enterprises, right? And that goes together with what I said before, not only the endpoint protection, but EDR and our services, MDR, managed detection and response. Together with that, we are heavily investing in the cloud workloads security. Mm-hmm. And that starts in 2021, is gonna be a very strong offering for our customers as well, together with our partners, right? So all together, we definitely see, as I was saying before, a very big opportunity, joint opportunity for our partners and ourselves, right? In terms of how we see our partners landscape for 2021, no change on the basics. We continue to have a 100% channel mentality. We always 100% work with and through our channel partners, right? But a couple probably of important things. The first one is that when it goes into the mid-size and large enterprises with our managed detection and response based on our EDR technology, that's the work that goes mostly with what we call our silver and gold partners, right? Mm-hmm. In that segment of our partners landscape, we are not looking at a massive increase of number of partners. Yes, we are interested and we are working in increasing the number, but I would say very carefully. We want to continue to work with a selected number of partners with those services, those technologies, in those type of on those type of customers. To make sure that we provide them with the support that they need and they have their business protected, right? On the other segment of our business, meaning the small and medium sized companies, our channel strategy, our sales strategy is slightly different, right? It continues to be a wider type of channel where, yes, we are increasing the number of partners as opposed to the silver and gold segments of our channel, where we definitely want to continue to have a narrow group of partners with which we work very closely.
Okay. At the virtual partner conference, you spoke about your intention to operate with a small, very few distributor in each country.
Yes.
Yes. Which is the goal of that decision?
Thank you for the question. As we see our distribution, we give a very high importance to the way that we co-work with our distribution, right? We don't believe that our channel partners are going to be better supported by working with more distributors. We believe that our channel partners are going to be better supported in all senses by working with a narrow group of distributors, which are very well supported and work very closely with our team at Bitdefender, right? We want to be important for our narrow group of distributors in the same way that they are very important to us. That very close partnership, for them to invest at the same level that we invest in our partnership, can only be with a selected group of partners, right? In that sense, it does depend per country, but in average, we are definitely looking at, and in fact, already we are already there, working with no more than two distributors per country with a very, very close partnership. That is the case in Italy with Avangate and Computer Grouse, as it is in most of the countries across the region. And again, it comes because of the importance that we give to that partnership. We need the distributors' investment, at least on the same way, I would say, at the same level of our investment, so that our channel partners are really well supported by the combination of Bitdefender distributors and the Bitdefender team.
Okay, Emilio, we thank you very much for your time and for your answer. We understood better the strategy of your channel strategy for this year and for the next time, 2021. We thank you very much for your time again, and we see for another interview.
Fantastic, Stefano. Thanks to you for your time. Definitely appreciate it. And look, keep safe. All the best for the following
months. All the best
months.
Also.
I hope that it goes also for you. Very well in Italy as in the rest of the country.
Yes, also you. Thank you very much.